easily take control of your drums by adding EQ and compression to each individual drum in the kit. I'm Zane, welcome to Simple Green Tech, and in this Tracktion Waveform tutorial, I'm going to show you how to easily use the plugin racks for multi-output instruments, specifically drums, and the plugin that I'm using for this example is MT Power Drumkit 2, which is a free plugin, and if you need it, I've linked to it down in the description. Right now, let's jump into the tutorial. All right, so I'm using Waveform Pro, but this will work exactly the same in Tracktion Waveform Free. And I'm starting with an empty project, but you can do this in an existing project if you want to. So what we first want to do is create a track. So we'll right click over here, create a new track, and then we want to add our plugin, which is MT Power Drumkit. And if you aren't sure about how to install third-party VST plugins in Tracktion, I'll link to the video that I did showing you how to do that, just in case you need it. And just so you know, this will work in other similar plugins like Easy Drummer, the Ugratone drum kits, which I really like, and also Satala it will work in, plus other plugins like this. So don't think you can only do this in MT Power Drum Kit 2. Now let's go into the mixer of our plugin, just to have a look in here. So we have kick, snare, hi-hats, toms, ride, bell, crash, and china. So we're going to need 7 tracks in total, including the one that we already have. So we need to add 6 additional tracks. Now you can do that by right-clicking here, create a new track, and keep doing that over and over again. Or we can go down here to tracks, and then create several tracks, and then you want to go over to 6 new tracks. And bam, we have 6 new tracks in there. Now what we want to do is rename each one of these. So I'm going to start with track 1, and we're going to call this kick. And you can order these in whatever order you want. I'm just going to go in this order. Track 2 is snare. Track 3 is toms. 4 is hi-hats. 5 is ride, 6 is crash, and 7 is china. So then what you want to do is go over to where the plugin is over here. You want to click on the MT Power Drumkit plugin and then right click on it, and then go down to wrap this plugin in a new rack plugin. So click on that. You can see now it's turned purple. And then what we need to do is hold down control on your computer keyboard, and then click and drag into the next track, and keep doing this for all of the tracks. Now, before we continue, I just want to ask, if you're enjoying this video so far and you're getting some value out of it, can you please give it a thumbs up? It really helps my channel out and I appreciate it so much. Now let's get back into Waveform. And you can see this is our plugin rack over here, and it's added all of our tracks, but you'll notice that the outputs are all coming from up here. So we're going to need to change that. And to open up your plugin interface now, if you want to go back into the interface, you just click on this picture in the center here, and it brings up the plugin interface. And you'll notice if we play the drums, it's going to all of these tracks, which is not what we want. So what we first need to do is adjust the plugin rack. So down here, you want to go to clear wiring. Click on that and then clear all output wiring. You can see it's got rid of that mess that was over here. Then we can go to connect wires and connect outputs sequentially. And you can see now it's all connected sequentially down over here. So let's open up our interface again and see what happens when we play the drums. Well, now everything's going through this one track. So what we need to do is go into the mixer, and you can see down along here, it says out 1. So everything's outputting to track 1 right now, which is our kick track. So let's go and change these. So snare is track 2, hi-hats are track 4, toms are track 3, ride is track 5, crash is track 6, and china is track 7. So now let's go back to our drum kit and see what happens when we play. You can see everything's playing on the right track now. And you can program or add your MIDI clips to any of these tracks. I recommend keeping it to the top track just to keep yourself organized. So let's just bring in one of these grooves here and I'll drag it over into here. And we'll see what it looks like when we're playing the drum kit on all of these tracks. And we can adjust the levels now for each of these tracks. You can add more plugins in there. But one thing you might want to do is create a drum bus. And to do that, you just want to click on your first track here, and then hold down Control on your computer keyboard, and click on each of these tracks. So they're all highlighted in red. And then if you just right click on any one of them, go to Create Submix Track Containing. And now, all of those are in our drum bus. And we can rename this to Drum Bus. And now you can add a bus compressor and some EQ to all of the drums, and this way it sort of glues everything together. Now sometimes you might want to have a separate bus for your cymbals and for your drums. So to separate these, if you already have them in your drum bus, you would just click and bring it up out of your drum bus like that. So now here's our drum bus with our kick, snare, and toms. And then we'll create another bus with all of our cymbals in it. And we'll call this one Hats and Cymbals. This bus is still getting all the information that we have from this one MIDI clip. And you can shrink these down by clicking over here, or you can expand them so you can see all of them. And this really helps you to stay organized if you have a lot of tracks in your projects. Now you can add an overall EQ and a compressor to all of your hi-hats and your cymbals, and you can add effects to your drum bus so your kick, snare, and toms get sort of glued together. If you want to see even more Tracktion Waveform tutorials from me, click up here, or click down here to see what YouTube recommends. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.